He was in the store. He's one of the owners. And he just told us that somebody was shot. We didn't know who it was at first. You know, we was just like, okay, I thought it was, you know, one of the employees. So we was kind of distraught at the time. But, you know, we heard my cousin in the background. You know, he was just basically like, man, he gone. Somebody shot him. He gone. And I'm like, who gone? You know, we just trying to figure out what was going on. And then you could hear my dad, you know, he was just like, stay with me, Dolph. Just stay with me, brother. You know, he kept saying it. So that's when we was like, okay, it was Dolph. So it was kind of... It was real fast. He said it was my dad was just like, it was real fast. It was a real quick situation. So we real hurt by it. He was a real, you know, good dude. He came to the store all the time. You know, when he was in Memphis, McHugh was one of his stops, you know. So it's really tearing us down a little bit. We pray for the family, you know. It's a senseless tragedy. We just really want them to know that we backing 100%. And we just really want, you know, we really just wish this would just stop. This is just too much for us, you know. So it's affecting our family now, because we do consider Dolph, you know, anytime you walk into there, you know, walk into Makita's, you consider family. When Dolph came here, he was considered family. He called my mama, mom, every time she came in, you know. I mean, it's hurting us a little bit. So we just...
You were on the phone with your dad when it happened?
It wasn't when it happened. It was right after. He called us like directly after, you know, the shots were fired and Dolph was hit.
And you can hear him saying, Dolph, stay with me.
Yeah, we heard him say that, and he was just, man, it's a lot.
Everyone's talking about how much he loved Makita's.
So. He did a lot. He was I got a video with him. He was telling us, you know, saying every time I come here, I can't leave without getting some chocolate chip and like fresh out the oven. This is it. So, chocolate chip and ice cream was his favorite. So, we gonna.
Was it inside of your store or right outside?
Well, from what I was hearing, it was inside the store. It was inside the store. So, you know, it's yeah. So we just. We just been standing here just hoping that, you know, because my mom want to, you know, see what's going on. She just, you know, we just want people to know that we hurting for them. We hurting about this. We hurting. So we want everybody to know. We want the family to know. You know, we love Dolph. He was a part of our family. We really appreciate him coming in, you know, in the store, supporting us anytime he can. So whatever the family need, you know what I'm saying, we just want them to know we here.
Makita's. Raven Winton is the operation manager of Makita's Cookies and the daughter of Pamela and Maurice Hill. Tonight, in her own words, she tells me what happened that day and how her family has been grieving the loss of young Dolph.
I freaked when I found out. I couldn't even drive, so please believe it hit us in a way that you guys couldn't even imagine, because like I said, he was considered a brother. That man did not deserve that. He was just in there to buy cookies for his family. And it's terrible that we can't even step outside of our house and feel comfortable in the neighborhood that he knew and loved and supported. But it has been a challenge. We have had a couple of sleepless nights since this happened. So we just want the city to know that we are so, so sorry that you guys had to endure this and see this.
And just days before the shooting, the store posted social media that young Dolph made a point to stop by on a regular basis. The mom and pop shop has been around for 20 years and opened their second location downtown a few years ago. But Dolph stopped at this one, another symbol of his dedication to the community.
That man did not deserve that. He was just in there to buy cookies for his family. And it's terrible that we can't even step outside of our house and feel comfortable in the neighborhood that he knew and loved and supported. Please pray for his family, because that's just that's unreal to me. I can't even imagine what they're going through. We just got support from young Dolph's wife. You know, she supported us, so we appreciate that. She's backing us, saying that, you know, he enjoyed the cookies. He was there to pick up cookies for us all the time. So please back them up, support them. And we do appreciate the support of the city, because they have been extremely supportive. A lot of people have been praying for us. They've been reaching out to us. They've been telling us that, you know, we got you guys back. You know, it's a senseless tragedy. We want the violence to stop. And whatever we got to do to get behind the city to get this to stop, we're going to do that. We need to. So we want the city to know, we want the public to know, just let's just create a lot of
peace. Hey, what's up? It's your boy, D. Smith. Make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. It's your boy, I'm out of here.